Hello everyone, and thanks for visiting Bluebeam Back to Basics. Today we'll be talking about a script that helps you set up your layer protocols prior to uploading a file to a studio session. For those of you I have not met personally, you can reach me at that phone number and email address, and we encourage you to visit our website where you can learn all about our Bluebeam training program. Hopefully this video will make you aware of a problem before it becomes one, or if you've already found the problem, maybe it'll help you solve it in a convenient way. Now, right up front, I have to say that this solution requires that you have Bluebeam Revu the Extreme Edition. It's the only edition that supports scripting, and that is how this solution is accomplished. Now, you may not be aware of it, but when you create a tool set and you put markups in those tool sets, you can pre-assign those markups to named layers. So I've got a collection of markups that all represent comments from an architect versus comments from an electrical contractor versus comments from a project manager versus comments from an inspector. And they all have different colors and they all go to different layers based on an agreed to set of standard protocols. If I go into a document like this one that has zero layers in it, and I start using these symbols and placing markups in a file with no layers, this is what happens. This is a copy of that file. As soon as I start making these markups, it automatically starts creating the necessary layers in order to support the protocols that we've all decided. And that's great. That works fine as long as you're working standalone at your own desktop. However, if I want to do the exact same thing in a studio session and I want all of my project participants to be able to utilize the tool sets that I've gone to the trouble of establishing and setting up, there's a problem with that. If I go into, this is an active studio session, and I have uploaded this file, which has no layers in it. In a studio session, I can go to those tool sets, and I can choose those exact same markups and place them into the file. And if I was working on my desktop alone, it would have created that layer automatically for me. But when you're in a studio session, it doesn't do it. What that is telling you is that before you take a file and put it into the cloud in a studio session, any layer names that you intend to use must pre-exist. So you need to create your layer protocols in any document that you're going to take to a studio session before you take it up there. Now, that could be a long and tedious process. Here's an example of a document that has just a small number of layers in it. But this is a real-world example of a customer of mine. It happens to be a highway department, and they were facing this issue. They needed to create new documents or receive documents from outside vendors that they are then going to take to the cloud for collaboration, and when they do, they want to use their tool sets with their pre-created, pre-assigned, pre-established layer naming convention. That can be accomplished with a two-line script, a very simple two-line script if you have the Extreme Edition. So here's how I accomplish that. This file is a single page PDF that simply has these markups drawn documenting what our layer names, colors, and protocols are. And that has been saved on my D drive under D:layer template.pdf. It's that simple. It is now a usable template that I can use so that, let's say I wanted to take this file to the cloud into a studio session. Boy, wouldn't it be great if I could steal from my template the layer protocols that I want and then quickly take it up into the cloud. Well, that can be done. I've got a script right here that when I click on it, what it does is it goes and it identifies that template and it grabs it. And what it does is it inserts it in front of page one of the currently active document. That automatically generates the list of layer names for me. So I'm going to run this script. Now I'm going to save this file and then go add it to an already active studio session. So I'll right click on it and tell it to add it to the open studio session. Now if I go look at my studio session, I've got the original file that's up there that doesn't have pre-created layers, and now I've got this new one that does as a result of that script having been run. Now, while I'm in the studio session, I can take advantage of my tool sets, and when I place an architectural cloud, or if I place an electrical cloud, or a project manager cloud, or an inspector cloud, or any other of the layer named specific markups, they're not only created, they're properly assigned to the designated layer because it was pre-created and just waiting for me and all other project participants to take advantage of it. Now, what does that script look like? It's very simple. I go into Document and Script, and I go down and I look at my layer setup script. And when I edit it, it's just two lines long. Anytime you start to enter a command in the script editor, it pops up a tooltip that tells you what the various parameters you need to take advantage of are. And in this example, line number one, the way it's set is it says insert a page. And then the zero indicates I want it to be inserted in front of whatever is currently page number one, which makes it page number one. That's what the zero is indicating. After the comma, it tells it specifically where to go and where to find the template PDF. After that comma, there are three falses. And what those are saying, they're communicating to the system saying, ignore the bookmarks, ignore the attachments, and ignore the properties of the template file. Then it gets to option number four, and it says true. It says don't ignore the layers. And that's what's making it import and apply those layers the second that template file gets brought in as page number one. Then it continues with ignore everything else in that template file. Then it goes to line number two, and line number two simply says, hey, remember that page we inserted it that created those layers? Delete it. But it happens so fast, you would never even see it. The reason it's available to me up here as a single button is purely because after I created the script, I went into the script editor, I selected it from my list of available scripts, and I said add to toolbar. When I told it to add it to toolbar, I've created, over the years, I've created a custom toolbar where I keep all of my favorite scripts, and I just added it in there. That's it. I hope you find this video helpful, and you'll review the other videos available as well.